Forrest. Forrest Gump. Do you want a chocolate? I could eat about 1.5 million of these. My mom always said life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Those must be comfortable shoes. I bet you could walk all day in shoes like that and not feel a thing. I wish I had shoes like that.
My feet hurt.
Mom always said there's an awful lot you could tell about a person by their shoes. Where they going? Where they been? I've worn lots of shoes. I think about it real hard. I could remember my first pair of shoes. Mama said they'd take me anywhere. She said they was my magic shoes. Open your eyes now.
Let's take a little walk around. How does it feel? His legs are strong, Miss Gump, as strong as ever seen. But his back's as crooked as a politician. But we're gonna straighten him right up now, aren't we, Forrest?
Now, when I was a baby, Mama named me after the great Civil War hero Nathan Bedford Forrest. She said we was related to him in some way, and what he did was he started up this club called the Ku Klux Klan. They'd all dress up in their robes and their bed sheets and act like a bunch of ghosts or spooks or something. They'd even put bed sheets on their horses and ride around. And anyway, that's how I got my name. Forrest Gump. Mama said that the forest part was to remind me that sometimes we all do things that, well, just don't make no sense.
They're better than you, Forrest. If God intended everybody to be the same, he'd have given us all braces on our legs.
Mama always had a way of explaining things so I could understand them. We lived about a quarter mile off Route 17, about half mile from the town of Greenbow, Alabama. That's in the county of Greenbow. Our house had been in Mama's family since her grandpa's grandpa's grandpa had come across the ocean about 1,000 years ago, something like that. Since it was just me and Mama and we had all these empty rooms, Mama decided to let those rooms out. Mostly the people passing through, like from, Mobile, Montgomery, place like that. And that's how me and Mama got money. Mama was a real smart lady.
Remember what I told you, Forrest. You're no different than anybody else is. Did you hear what I said, Forrest? You're the same as everybody else. You are no different.
Your boy's different, Ms. Gump. His IQ is 75.
Well, we're all
education, so she took me. She wanted me to have the finest education, so she took me to the Greenbow County Central School. I met the principal and all.
I want to show you something, Ms. Gump. Now, this is normal. Forrest is right here. The state requires a minimum IQ of 80 to attend public school, Mrs. Gump. He's gonna have to go to a special school. Now, he'll be just fine.
What does normal mean anyway? he might be a bit on the slow side. But my boy Forrest is going to get the same opportunities as everyone else. He's not going to some special school to learn how to retread ties. We're talking about 5 little points here. There must be something can be done.
We're a progressive school system. We don't want to see anybody left behind.
Is that Mr. Gump? Mrs. Gump?
He's on vacation. Looked easy, but oh, what happened?
First, Mama, what's vacation mean?
Vacation?
Where Daddy went.
Vacation's when you go somewhere and you don't ever come back.
Anyway, I guess you could say me and Mama was on our own. But we didn't mind.